This is a production of PBS 39.
Good evening. Thanks so much for joining us. I'm Amy Burkett. Are the kids climbing the walls, moody or unable to concentrate? You might think it's some form of attention deficit hyperactivity disorder, but it might be a lot simpler. Experts say that your children might be over-caffeinated and undernourished. And the cause could be right in your refrigerator, at the local supermarket or fast food restaurant. Grover Silcox reports.
Some folks call this a natural rush. Some folks call this a rush, though not so natural. For the average Joe, a cup of Joe might provide that small boost to start the day. But for the average kid, the little boost that comes from caffeinated drinks might go too far.
One thing to remember is that caffeine can be addictive. Just like in adults, it can be for children as well. And more so for children because of their lower body weight.
Dr. Amy Vyas, a pediatrician with Lehigh Valley Hospital's Outpatient Pediatrics, recently wrote about kids and caffeine for Healthy You, the hospital's bi-monthly newsletter.
I'm not sure that everyone is aware of the acute effects that are related with caffeine. I think sometimes they may be attributed to other things, like, oh, maybe the child has some behavioral disorders, or it might be just the temperament of the child.
But parents might say, well, my kids aren't allowed to drink coffee. Even so, they probably are drinking other beverages with caffeine.
The obvious ones are sodas, like, Coke, Pepsi, Mountain Dew. But ones I think people sometimes generally forget is the iced teas, which include Snapples, and some of the other energy drinks that you find at the convenience stores that look like juices or natural that actually have extra caffeine that are added into it, including Red Bull, which is a big one.
Dr. Mike Cawley of Bucks County Pediatrics in Warminster sees the marketing of these so-called energy drinks as troubling.
Caffeine in itself is a relatively safe compound. The concern that pediatricians have is the increased amount of caffeines that are being added to so-called energy drinks, which are being marketed as a device to make the kids more social, make them perform better in school, allow them to do better on the playing field, which there is some benefit to caffeine in those three areas. Unfortunately, there's a very thin line between the benefit of caffeine and the side effects.
Caffeine side effects, so often observed in adults, are frequently more pronounced in kids.
They can have jitteriness, nervousness, mood swings. It can be associated with elevated heart rate and blood pressure as well. And in some cases also can cause a lot of stomach aches and what's called like gastrointestinal distress.
Jitteriness that leads to irritability that then can lead to difficulty with concentrating.
Pediatricians advise parents to limit their kids' caffeine consumption.
You're going to drink only
water.
Yes, very good. Oh, you guys are so smart.
One guideline suggests that preschoolers consume no more than 45 milligrams of caffeine per day, an amount equivalent to a can of soda. For adolescents who want to join their friends at the local coffee house, Dr. Vyas suggests some leeway.
If anything, maybe in late teens, you can certainly start having, half a cup to a cup.
Cultivating a taste for coffee is one thing, but some caffeinated products seem designed to cultivate something less benign.
Many of the different drinks that are being marketed are actually using names from the drug culture. One was very recently taken off the market in May of this year, and its name was cocaine. And it was an energy drink that contained about 100 milligrams of caffeine.
So how do parents control the amount of caffeine a child ingests, whether in chocolate, sodas, energy drinks, or any other product?
I oftentimes, both implicitly and explicitly, will remind the parents that I work with that you're in charge. You have to convey to your kids what's safe and what's not safe.
Too often, kids are replacing healthy foods with highly caffeinated and sugar-filled products.
Children are not getting the obvious source of calcium that they may have been getting from milk, and really they're not getting that at a vital time where they need that calcium and phosphorus for bone and tooth development.
Parents eager to control their kids' caffeine consumption can ask their doctor for advice or go to websites such as Energy Fiend for more information about the wide variety of caffeinated products. But perhaps the best way for parents to control their kids' cravings is to control their own first.
If a kid doesn't have a can of Red Bull in the home refrigerator, there's probably not going to be much pressure for him to drink Red Bull out in the community.
For Tempo, I'm Grover Silcox, reporting.